This is TWiT.
So, as we know, last week's podcast was VPNFilter, talking about this collection of routers that had known vulnerabilities being exploited by, we believe, actually there's strong forensic evidence to suggest that it is the APT28 group, aka Fancy Bear, which is operating out of Russia, largely targeting the Ukraine. Since the takedown of this large botnet of composed of all these routers, and remember that the toknowall.com domain was taken away from VeriSign's control over to the FBI, that were then using it in order to monitor the botnet and to get command and control away from those who had it. What's happened is, since that time, the Ukrainian IP space has been actively scanned. And a number of security firms, JASK and GreyNoise Intelligence, have both been watching the net in the wake of this takedown and have seen, 8 IPs scanning port 2000 of the Ukrainian IP space. Port 2000 is the one that the MikroTik routers unfortunately have open, that allows them to be taken over. And so this strengthens this sense that existed before that this was from Russia and aimed at Ukraine networking devices, and that this is still an active campaign even post commandeering of the command and control server. And what's odd is that one of the IPs, 9.110.0.5, well, 9 dot anything, the whole 9 dot network is owned by IBM and always has been. So I presume some obscure machine somewhere, I mean, it's, you know, not at IBM central headquarters, just some random machine in somewhere in on the IBM network at that IP, probably, I mean, unless it's a security scan, which is certainly possible, is probably got some malware in it and is scanning for Ukraine-based routers. Also, there's two IPs closely related to each other in Russia, two in Brazil, one somewhere in the U.S. Oh, no, actually three in Russia. One in the U.S. and one in Switzerland. So it looks like there are, you know, a few systems. Without looking to see what they're all about, it's hard to know if they're malicious or not. But, you know, I think what we're going to see, and we'll be talking about another class of attacks here in half an hour or so. These internet exposed devices are going to be a constant source of trouble, and I don't know how they get fixed over time.